All right, welcome back. I had recently come across this story that I wanted to share. It actually says, please share, so I hope that's okay, because that's what I'm going to do. And then I will give my thoughts about it. It's a post from Phrase Hermetic Supplies, and it's talking about a new burger place that opened up right next to them that's harassing them. They say, new Christian burger shop harassing pagan shop. Burning times? Question mark. Please share. A few of our neighbors from the adjoining cul-de-sac told us that the burger shop guy who just moved in next door was basically talking about us behind our back and asking everyone if they knew what we did in here. So burger shop guy is already annoying and seems to have gotten his information on paganism and witchcraft from Hollywood movies where everything is evil and they must be in the store sacrificing children or something, which the Christianity has already taught him anyway because, you know, it can't have a competing religion. We have been at this location for a year and a half, so I'm not sure what he was thinking after being here a week. Well, he's probably thinking that you're evil and that it's his duty as a fine, upstanding Christian man to wage a holy war against you. Of course, it was going to get back to us. He has apparently been working very hard to get the landlords on his side. They are both Christian. I probably didn't take too much doing then. And though we have no problems whatsoever with any religion, and we cater to all religions from pagan priestesses to Catholic priests, I guess it's not always reciprocated. Well, no, why would it be? Christ taught love and tolerance, but Christianity, the religion, teaches intolerance. There's only one God, and everything else is the devil. It's black and white, and there is no in-between. Even the things that don't seem to be the devil are disguised as the devil. So, Christianity is very intolerant of other religions, faiths, and practices. They want freedom of religion for themselves, just not for others, who they consider to be practicing a false religion. So, it's not surprising to say the least. You'll find that Christianity, the religion, and the actual teachings of Christ are two completely different things. His people knocked some product off our shelf and they broke with whatever they were doing next door. No matter how many times I tell them that the walls are thin, a few inches, they don't care. Well, that's most neighbors, as anyone who's ever lived in an apartment can tell you. And then you finally move out of the apartment and get a house, and you're like, oh, thank you. But even today, with the house, I still have noisy neighbors who wake me up, who don't care. It's not uncommon for me to sleep in a little bit because I work from home and may be up at night doing magic. I mean, just the other day, I had the neighbor across the street wake me up because he wanted to play with his brand new noisy RC car in the street in front of my house before 9 a.m. And I'm a light sleeper. I'm wondering what the hell that noise is. I wake up, I look out the window, and he's out in the street playing with his RC car. So neighbors are just kind of like that no matter where you are at or who you are. He said that he doesn't owe us a heads up and he refuses to pay for what broke. What has been bothering me the most was last night the landlord's wife called me. I had sent them an email letting them know that I invited the neighbor over to have an idea of how thin the walls were due to the problems in the past. Common courtesy is not a virtue to him. Burger Boy said that the fact that we sold curses could be taken as a threat. He then told us that he was going to buy up the strip, then he said that he was going to get his buddies in the shop next door and squeeze us out, and outnumber us. He threatened our business and what we need to operate multiple times. He lied to the landlord and said that he got a death threat over the internet. He provided no proof, but was believed anyway. I said if that was true, he would have gone to the cops. She said to prove it. To me? Sorry, but I don't have to prove a negative. He is the one making accusations. The burden of proof is upon him. The landlord's wife then told me that everyone in the strip is afraid of me and no one likes me. Well, yes, people fear the occult. They fear what they do not understand. Nor do they want to understand, when it's much easier to just take the simple explanation that they're fed to them. It's of the devil. It's evil. Stay away from it. That's funny because we know everyone around here and give each other business. I buy tacos, they buy positive energy spells. I get my car fixed next door, they buy luck and money spells. I called her a liar, which is always the easiest way to get somebody on your side. She made it clear that they are just trying to get us out. Arlise says we do meditations and sell books and candles. I'm pretty sure they never looked into what we did until now. Burger Boy mentioned he was a Christian, and when I tried to explain to her that this may be the reason for his actions, she said that she couldn't respect me for mentioning that. I told her that I wasn't going to put up with her BS and word twisting. My grandma is a Christian, and so are some of our customers. She kept asking and raising her voice and yelling into the phone, "Why did you mention it then? Why did you bring it up?" Well, I kept repeating because he brought it up. What am I supposed to think? He used it to play victim to them, I'm sure. I feel like they are just trying to work together to push us out. Probably at this point, yes. Especially her telling me that the entire strip hated me and not caring that he yells about us through the wall. I'm not sure what to do at this point. We worked so hard building this shop. Phrase Hermetic Supplies. Well, I will tell you what you shouldn't have done. You shouldn't have gotten into an argument with the landlord's wife, because now you have polarized and set her against you. If she wasn't on his side before, she certainly is now. Calling someone a liar and losing your temper with them is not going to help your case by winning their favor. Ideally, you shouldn't have had any contact with the landlord's wife at all, or the landlord for that matter. You want to keep them as far out of it as you can. And you were the one that initiated the complaint because things were being broke along that wall. But landlords don't care. They don't want to hear that. They want to just make money off their property. So ideally, they should never have been brought into it. And all your breakable items should have been put on the other side of the store. And all your non-breakable items should have been along that wall. But now the damage is done and you have an uphill battle. Now, in my opinion, the first thing you want to do is apologize to the landlord's wife, even if she's in the wrong. You'd be amazed at what a simple apology can do. I remember this one time back when I was living in an apartment. I got into a heated discussion over the phone with the landlord's manager, and she got so angry with me that she cussed me out and hung up on me. And I thought, well, this isn't good for me. I better do something about this, or she's going to make my life a living hell. So I called her back immediately and said, "I'm sorry. I did not mean to set you off. That was never my intention. I just want to work this out. Is there any way that we could possibly work on this and come to a solution that benefits us both?" And just from that simple apology, she not only calmed down to where we can reach an agreement, but I also became one of her favorite tenants because now I had her respect. I know it's hard to do, especially when you're in the right, but sometimes you gotta just take one for the team. You have to decide which is more important, your shop or stubborn pride, because your pride should be your shop. And it's just not good business practice to be picking fights with the landlord or his wife. I would call her up and say, "You know what? I'm sorry. I apologize. I lost my temper. I was frustrated because I know that I didn't do this, and I should never have spoken to you like that. That was highly unprofessional of me. I truly want to be able to make this work. Please accept my apology. And come by my store. I have some products I'd love to give you as a gift."
"And then load them up with a curse."
"No, don't do that. The gift should be a legitimate peace offering. It could be something simple, some incense and candles, etc. This gives her the opportunity to actually come into your store and see what you do, to show that there's nothing nefarious going on, that you're just a supply shop. And who knows, maybe while she's in there, Burger Boy might bang on the wall, causing things to fall. And so she could witness it firsthand. You never know. But if she declines to come and say, well, the offer still stands, anytime you want to come in, I'll have something for you. And I am truly sorry, for I was way out of line." And that may be all it takes to smooth things over with the landlord's wife. Or not. Some people are just stubborn and can hold on to a grudge. Which brings us to the next thing that you should do. Can anybody guess what that is? Anyone? As if I'm really waiting on you to answer me. It should be obvious. Magic. Magic is the answer. Magic is always the answer. I mean, this is a hermetic supply shop. It should have immediately turned to magic as soon as this guy started harassing them. I mean, he's expecting it anyway. Because he said, oh, the fact that they sell curses could be taken as a threat. Because this is how most people think. Unfortunately, they're not far off the mark. Because a lot of people in your position would immediately turn to throwing a curse at them. In fact, some of the replies to this post, people were saying that they are going to start targeting this burger place.
New target acquired.
Yeah, don't do that. I mean, yes, I know they threatened your business, but a curse or hex should only be used as a last resort. I mean, sometimes you got to. When all else fails and they're not taking the hint, then you may need to throw at them. But there are other ways to resolve the issue. There's all kinds of things you can do. You can use magic to influence and change their mind and make it to where they don't want to harass you. You can bind them and make it to where you're not their biggest concern. They have other things to deal with. Or you can even be generous and make it to where they get a better deal for a better place somewhere else that they'd be crazy to pass up. Well, why would anyone do this if they were treating you the way they were treating you? Well, maybe they're like that because their life sucks. And you're in a unique position to help better that life to make them just a little less douchey. Some people are out for revenge and others just want to solve the problem. It would get them out of your hair and no one would have to get hurt for it. The fact that you could throw a blessing just as well as a curse, but most people opt for the curse first, speaks volumes. And it really shouldn't be that way. As magicians, we strive to be better than the normal petty person. Now, granted, there are some boundaries that you just don't allow people to cross, but for the most part, you try to resolve things without having to throw a hex or a curse, which will only make more work for you in the long run anyway when you have to uncross for it. You don't have to uncross for influencing or blessing someone. So I just wanted to share my take on it. I'm quite surprised that magic isn't the first option that they turn to, considering that they're a hermetic supply shop. They have the supplies. They have the know-how. Magic should have been the go-to. But instead, it got handled how and I don't like to use this term, a muggle would handle it. An everyday, ordinary person who doesn't practice magic would handle it, which is what escalated the problem. But sometimes we're too close to the problem to be able to see what's right in front of us. I don't think it's too late. I think that if you get on the magic and the apology now, that you may be able to turn it around. And I wish you all the best in doing so. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Leave a like and share it if you did. It helps others to find it. Join me at all the usual places, facebook.com/mindandmagic, Twitter @FraterXavier. We're on Patreon and Subscribestar and even have a BitChute channel. Check out our shirts over at Teespring, where we have many designs to choose from, including a limited edition that will only be available for a short time. I want to thank you all for joining me, and I wish you all the very best. I'll see you soon. Take care.